growth engine. The idea is that, you know, you cannot just work on making the number of your users big. It just does not go like that. You'll have to identify a particular type of a growth engine that will work for you. So let's look at the growth engines. So this is a concept given by Eric Ries in the book Lean Startup. I would recommend that book for every one of you. So these are the three engines. Viral engine of growth. Of course, you heard of this word virality and all. If this would suit only if you have a concept, an idea, a product which needs volume. You're not asking your users to pay, or even if you're asking them, that's very minimal, you know, say $1 a month, something like that. If that's kind of a service, if that is the kind of product you have, and what you need is a big number of users, a very big number of users, then only you are going to go for this kind of a growth engines. Now, how do you measure this? The idea is that this is your growth engine, then the key metrics, the key thing which you have to see is the number of users that are being brought by your existing user. You know, so what happens is, why are we talking about this thing? Because when you'll be applying your growth hacks, it's not that you'll be doing everything and you'll be looking at everything else to see how things are going. No, you'll have to focus. So in case of viral engine of growth, you'll have to focus on bringing more and more people all the time. And what are you going to measure, what are you going to work on is that when there's one existing user, how can he bring more users? And what is the number of more users being brought by this existing user? And of course, we'll again talk about more of ideas how to do that.
So basically, for companies who work more on transaction models, something like Savan or something like that, Can we keep Savan for this?
Yes.
Pay a monthly fee minimum?
Very, very low. If the fee is very low, then normally, as we have said, quite low fee or free for users, those are the ideas which qualify for viral engine group.
A blog, for example.
A
website.
Right. And there you'll have to work on features like invite of your social friends. And like, you know, if you have to do something, then get two people. Invite two people and then you get this kind of feature. So those are things. Yeah, those kind of things. The second is sticky engine of growth. So if yours is a subscription where you ask for say 1,000 rupees per month, you know, a moderate subscription fee, then this thing comes into the picture. So what you have to do is that you get a user and the thing is going to work for you only if it stays with you. Every month he keeps paying say 500 rupees, 600 rupees or 1,000 rupees to you. Then it will be very difficult for you if you try to go for viral engine. You know, it's very, very naive for us that we want to get more and more users. But what is the mistake you're going to do? If say sticky engine suits you, the mistake you're going to fall for is that you would lose the focus on your existing users. And what will happen? You'll keep getting new users, and your existing users, they've used your service for 1 month, they are registered. But from the second or third month, they have stopped paying, and after 6 months, you have a big user base, but the revenue are less. And you don't know what's happening. Because you were working on a wrong engine. You were working on viral, but what suited. So, what are the things you'll be focusing more in this case? Say discount on new purchase. So you'll tell him, okay, you come back to us, we'll give you 10% discount. Or if you're a loyal user, you commit to stay there for more than 6 months, we reduce your fee. So those are the things you have to focus on. Reduce your focus on getting new customers, but increase your focus on making your customers stick.
Retention.
And then the paid engine of growth, of course, if you can afford, if yours is a very high ticket size, you know, you just make a sale and that one sale, maybe you're making a B2B software or an enterprise thing where you just charge, say 8,000 rupees for a year. So that's a good thing. So there you can afford paid engine. What you'll be using? Maybe Facebook ads, maybe Google ads. And there again, there are different matrices. So there is average acquisition cost for one user. If it is less than the total lifetime value of that customer, the amount of money he's going to pay you throughout life. If it is less than what are you supposed to do? Make profit and reinvest your profit. And that will become your engine. Yeah, okay. So what's happening? You say spend 1000 rupees to a customer and then you make say around 5000 of revenue, but the profit comes out to be say 1200 rupees. Okay, so ultimately you are in 200 rupees profit. You invest this 1000 rupees again to get another customer. Okay, and you keep doing that, and that becomes your growth engine. So that's the idea. The idea is that we have to, you know, we have to be focused, we have to understand what's going to work for us. We cannot be just like, you know, working for everything and trying to get users. It does not happen like that.